Hello, 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 everyone. How are all of you? Hopefully you're all doing well. If not, I do apologize. Hope that your day gets better. So, first things first, a friend of mine had a brand new account because he lost his old one and followed it, so we need to draw a card for that. So, let us draw a card. So, for King of the North 84's follow, got a card called Determined. Guys could use a Cyber Crushing from Mega Man trading card game. So today we're going to do unlock the rest of the Alliance raids. Maybe do some of the other raid content that we need to yet unlock. And then maybe some Hildebrand and some Roulettes. Who knows? We'll see. I mean, once we get all the raid stuff unlocked and all the Hildebrand stuff done, we'll be moving over to my main, pretty much on a permanent basis from a stream standpoint, and this will just become like my YouTube video. Content creation character. We're getting closer to that point. So much closer to that point. Oh. character's name is so poor. Yeah, someone trade a high quality. More levels. And some such. It's not yet 30. Gladiator and Marauder. So much. Okay, sorry about that. just hear a weird sound and just couldn't figure out what it was. Seven more. That was a much crappier experience than the other fate.
Tales of the Lord.
Spades are good, just disconnected for whatever reason. What's going on with my computer, but it's doing some weird nonsense. back at the bottom of the queue, unfortunately. Just looking something up here real quick. Sorry for the inconvenience. But I mean, I am watching the queue, and so. Just in case it somehow decides to pop. Part is I missed out on that experience right there.
Thank you.
I thought I was still going to have another half hour to go to finally get to bed. Nope. There it is.
Thank you all for joining on the Arik today. It is our day to attend Osama no Tabi no Anbi as you will see itadakimasu.
Send the Ego Collective. Okay. Hopefully now there's volume. I'm hoping there's volume now. Please let me know if there's not. And I just instantly got bounced the fuck off because I Oh, good. I can actually get back to trying to play the game badly as... Probably came because of the disconnect earlier. How are you, North? Tired. Yeah, that's good. Glad you did. It's been quite some time since we've seen you come by a stream. So many things that you've events you missed. Like, there's a clip of one of the worst moments, the worst mistakes I've ever made in any kind of, shooter, someone did. And it's like, I, as embarrassing as it is, I cannot bring myself to get rid of it. Well, I'm sorry you weren't getting the notifications, but just remember, pretty much, and this goes for everyone else, every night at 12 a.m. Eastern, we pretty much are going live. There are certain exceptions, like This Friday will probably, well, for me, it would actually end up being Saturday when I would be streaming. But later this week will probably be one of those nights where maybe a very short, real late night stream that we end up doing. Because we'll be hanging out with some friends and seeing Black Adam. The first DC movie I can say in quite some time that I've actually been wanting to see. Was Birds of Prey after the second Suicide Squad or before? May not be the best move because some of the cast aren't wanting to refilm any of the scenes that involve. not a trash fight. That's different. Well, I mean, they can. I mean, considering how shit most of the DC movies have been. I mean, hell, even the good ones were considered shit for one reason or another. Well, there's the typical evil child girl in red dress. Thank you. Although I already read a spoiler-free review for Black Adam. You don't want to know. I'll say it wasn't good, it wasn't bad. These were critics that have even done similar criticizations of Disney. Well, I mean, generally from, as I'm not really a big DC fan, looking at it from pure, you're looking at the movies that I have watched from purely just a moviegoer's perspective. I mean, have most of them been anywhere near as good to me as like a Marvel movie? No. I can usually find a lot bigger problems in pacing, storytelling, and action sequences with DC movies. If not quite a few, just horrible acting choices. I mean, Marvel's made some bad acting calls. I will give them that. And they've certainly made some blunders in their story writing. Usually in not doing too many characters at once. And not giving enough time for them to actually grow. It's a lot of bigger films. They got a lot more people in them. It's just like, why am I supposed to give a shit about this person? Whereas usually with DC films, it's just like, okay, this was just bad plot with, okay, action sequences are good, but acting is just atrocious. Like, watching Aquaman, the original Aquaman, which I watched like just a couple months ago, the only actor that did a good job acting-wise, I'd have to say, was the guy playing Aquaman. I can't remember. Jason Momoa. Everyone else, shit job. I mean, the story was kind of meh. The action was all really good. But everything else about it was kind of... I still haven't actually watched that. The only Henry Cavill Superman movie I've watched was him and Ben Affleck when they went head to head. I will say, I can't really judge that film as I have not actually watched it, so... But then again, also, I have very little interest towards Superman in general, just because his storylines, the entire arc for his character growth just doesn't interest me in any way. And yeah, I will give him that. What will it take for these things to die and stay dead? An energy signal. Watch which way it turns. No, stop them! Honestly, your favorite Superman arc will always be the War of the Five Supermen when the real Superman was dead. Ow. See, I mean, I just don't get the appeal of it. Thank you. I mean, I guess I'm also, generally, if you look at most of the comic book characters I rather enjoy reading, they're really not necessary heroes in the first place. They're mostly all anti-heroes. The other characters, not so much, but at least in the one's case, definitely. I would actually call a scoundrel out of the lot that I like to read would probably be Constantine. Constantine would definitely, I'd say, could be classified as a scoundrel. Well, this has got a few things. Use that, use. Use that and that. Can't let it keep opening. Back me up here, 2B. What are you doing? I'll help you from the other side. Take care of Konog. Well, I guess Deadpool could also be considered a scoundrel. Probably more so than Constantine is. Alert! Unit 2B and 9S vital systems offline. Saved data found in memory regions. Initiating playback. This is Yorha Unit 2B recording. We discovered that our enemies, the white-clothed androids, the tower, the colossal girl, came from that white orb. As did 9S and I. It's a gate between worlds. And its purpose is to destroy this one. As long as 9S and I are on this side, it can never be closed. We have to go. But we'll save the memories of our reunion, and of the time we spent in this world with you. Some things are just too precious to lose. So, thank you. Playback ended. I actually just rewatched the Deadpool movie here earlier. Lolly, that scared the shite out of me. Ho! Oh. The tower just up and disappeared. It sort of folded in on itself in the blink of an eye. Glad to see that you're safe, though. Relieved that she is, that you and Kunog are safe, the Dixite Chief wishes to know Vanog's fate. So, what happened in there? Well, I won't pretend I understand half of that. Can't say metaphysics is my area of expertise. Still, I knew that those androids in white and their weird orb were trouble. And you're saying that you gave them what for, so they won't be coming back? Which is good, right? Glad to hear it. Thanks for risking your neck for us. Where's Anog, though? And your android friends? For that matter, it seems like they should have come back with you. Sadly, they will not be joining us. No, she... But why? It just... don't seem fair. I was holding out hope, you know, that everyone would be fine and life would go back to normal. I should have known better, sure, but... So we'll need to tell the villagers again. As for Kunog, can you speak with him? I managed to talk him out of running back in there as soon as he woke up, but this... might be better coming from you. Or maybe I'm just a coward. Excuse me. You're back, but where's everyone else? You're not going to like the news. Not at all. No, she can't be gone. She wouldn't leave me forever. Because she did, there'd be no one left who... A letter from Anog? Kunog, I've been to another world. I've seen it. How did it go? Something for the missus? Wicked White, we thought this was gone for good. She'll be glad to have it back. It's all she has left of her parents. Why didn't Kanon come in person, though? He must know we'd want to thank him. No, not him, too. Chasing these dwarves down is not my idea of a good evening. Now that you're all here, I have an important announcement. Illusion has put an end to those machines and their plot. That means the danger's past, but more importantly, that's time we look to the future. We'll need to come together. Hold your iron frogs. Even though things are gone, this ain't over. The culprit needs to be brought to justice. How can you expect people to move forward if we don't set an example? That's right, we want to see consequences. Death, mutilation. Do you really? We need to talk them down or we'll never get anywhere with this bloodthirsty bastards. The most prudent course is to cooperate with Glog and rid the village of the guilty party. Then everything will be as it was. If it weren't Glog when it was suggested, he's the elder. He knows how these things work. If not, then... No, don't be ridiculous. Justice should be swift and decisive, I say. Nothing is so satisfying as a headsman's axe coming down. Why shouldn't be? Punish one person and everyone feels better for it. That's justification enough. Anything would be better than feeling like this. No, no, that's not justice. All we need is one or two people to take the blame, then the rest of us can get back to our normal lives. Wouldn't you? The way I see it, anyone here would throw away you to the eaters in a heartbeat for their own gain. You or me. Those backstabbers. The sooner we do away with the culprit, the sooner we can all relax. You know, I'm right. Glock thinks so too. Ah, that play won't work on me. I don't have anyone to worry about. No family, no friends, no lovers. I don't have anyone. I only need to do what Glock says, right? Then he won't blame me, and whatever happens, it won't be my fault. But then it'll be my responsibility, no matter what happens. Someone else should be the one. Well, they've slowed down a bit at least, thanks for that. Still sober, eh? Then I'll ask, what do you reckon we should do? Maybe the outsider's right. We'll never agree on who should take the blame for the attack. Which means the real problem is... Glag. I did feel a lot more confident before he started telling us to listen to other perspectives. He's just trying to turn us against each other, but he's the elder here. Shouldn't he have seen our village's fiery destruction by skybound machines coming? What? No! No one could have foreseen this, no matter how wise they are or how hard they try. No one's right every time. We've all made mistakes here, believe me. Anog, Konog, Glog, the whole lot of you, and me. All of us. We failed each other. And he's right. Sorry you had to see that. I may not be cut out for public speaking. I don't give up on putting Calmer back together, though, in whatever way I can.
want to check something here. After I see to some preparation. It comes, my doom has come. Doom, oh, it's just you. Sorry, force of habit. So, is it time to rebuild that is? Everyone's here. Good, let's get right to it. I have an idea that I want to run by the two of you. In order to rebuild, we're going to need lots of supplies and willing hands, neither of which we have a whole heap of at the moment. But then I thought, what if we availed ourselves of the technology used by the machines? The wealth of parts they left behind, we have all the materials we need to build, rebuild, and upgrade our automata to do the work. Not only would it be a practical since we'd be using the force behind our destruction for our salvation, it's also poetic. For your part in this, I'd ask you to venture into the tunnels and gather those items that what might be useful. Whatever you find, you can bring to our friend here. He'll examine the objects to see how they might be put to use. And that's about it. So what do you think? Sounds like a plan to me. Good, good. With this rebuilding can finally commence. We prove to everyone that you can keep us dwarves down, except maybe with copious amounts of grog. That's been an issue historically. Well, I'd best be getting back to my post. Without someone breathing down their necks, our miners are liable to stand and ground their thumbs up their arses. If you have any questions, you can direct them at our friend here. Between you and me, we're probably doomed to fail. But if it's going to hell up in any way, there's no point in delaying it. That's to say, if you're ready to begin, then so am I. Okay, so the rest of that will be some YouTube content we do.